Hello and welcome to Comcast Newsmakers. I'm Kevin Rader from WTHR. Well, first he was a police officer, then he was a city councilman. Now he enters his third term, as second year of his third term, as mayor of Lafayette. And he also just happens to be sitting right here. Mayor Tony Roszworski, welcome to Comcast Newsmakers.
Kevin, thank you for having me.
First of all, let me say that yours is a name I hear every 4 years as a possibility as lieutenant governor. And yet, it never happens. Is this something that you don't want to happen? Or what's going on there?
Well, I've been flattered to have been in that discussion over the last few years. But for me, as I've told people, the timing is just not right for me. I've told people, and I absolutely mean this, it's more important to me to be dad than any other title. And I still have two girls that are at home that are involved in basketball and volleyball and 4-H and we're involved in our church. And, it's just not the right time for me. I'm not going to miss those family times. I guess I'm not a political junkie. I'm just not going to put that before my family. And so the timing has just never been right for me. And, I will continue to look at those opportunities as the years move on. The girls are a junior and a senior now, so I'm getting closer to being an empty nester. And we'll see as things progress. But right now, dad's my most important title.
Well, it's a compliment to you that your name keeps surfacing.
Well,
I should say that.
Thank you.
Let's go to the business front. What do you have going there? Some changes with aluminum.
Yeah, we've been very fortunate here in our community. We landed a giant Chinese aluminum plant here in Lafayette that will open up in the next couple months. It's called Nanshan. It's about $161 million investment right now in our community, almost 600,000 square feet are under roof. So that the second press is here, and it is getting ready to open in a few months. I think what makes the story a little bit unusual is just down the road, about 2.5 miles, we have Alcoa, which is another aluminum, an American aluminum company here in our community. And we just won about $100 million expansion of that aluminum plant to create aluminum lithium, the third generation of aluminum lithium, which will compete with the composites in the aerospace industry. And so, that's kind of a unique situation, a brand new Chinese aluminum company. It's Nanshan's first investment in an aluminum plant in the United States here in Lafayette. Just down the road, an American company making a huge $100 million investment in the community. And we feel very fortunate to have that and those types of advanced manufacturing jobs that they are creating in our community.
Do these mean jobs?
Absolutely. It means 200 to 300 jobs at Nanshan and 75 jobs at Alcoa. So these are, and they're good jobs, good paying jobs with benefits. They're the kind of jobs that you want to create in your community.
Now tell me about the advanced manufacturing initiative that ties this all together.
Well, one of the things about winning, although projects is you do have to continue to have the workforce to fill those jobs. And if you want to create more jobs and attract new companies, that workforce piece is absolutely critical. And what we were finding, because we had been successful, we have an expansion at SIA going on and several of our other plants, that we begin to see a gap, a skill set gap. And we were hearing that from our local manufacturers, that they were reaching that point where they were finding it difficult to find employees with the skill sets necessary to fill those jobs. And that training curve was so long that that's hard on the bottom line. It's hard to get those orders out, and it was a real issue for them. So working together as a region, we put together a program with Ivy Tech called Advancing Manufacturing. And what that consists of is candidates who can pass a drug screen and a background check and have what we believe the opportunity to be successful can take this program 140 hours through Ivy Tech.
I'm sorry, we're about out of time, but they take that class at Ivy Tech?
Yeah, they take that class at Ivy Tech. They pass that class. The businesses have agreed then to move those people to the front of the hiring list. Okay. And we're helping our local businesses fill that gap. And we have about 300 of those jobs available.
Mayor, thanks for joining me.
Thank you.
I'm Kevin Rader.